Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be discussing about antenna array. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of antenna array. After that, I'll explain you linear antenna array and planar antenna array. At last, I'll derive equation of electric field for n element antenna array. So let us begin this video with first agenda, that is basics of antenna array. See, in antenna array, we use group of antenna elements. You will be observing with many wireless communication applications, we need to have long distance communication. And long distance communication is possible only if you have narrow beam. To have narrow beam, with antenna, we have only two methods. One is to have large size of antenna. If you have large size antenna, you can have narrow beam. And with the use of narrow beam, one can communicate to long distance. Second method is to have antenna array. In antenna array, we have group of antenna elements. Because of multiple antenna elements, we can have narrow beam by which we can communicate to long distance. Using antenna array, there are few advancements that we added with antenna structure. Like you can have increased gain because of group of antenna elements. But obviously, if you have single element, then you will be having lower gain. If you have multiple antenna elements, then gain of antenna will increase. Right. See, because of antenna array, we can have narrow beam. As I have told you, if you have group of antenna elements, then you can have narrow beam by which you can communicate to long distance. So antenna array, that we use it for long distance in general, right? See, third advancement can be beam steering without physical movement. See, in applications like radar, we need to have steering of beam. Like if we want to track the target, if target is there in motion, then antenna beam that we need to steer towards target. With the use of antenna array, we can steer the beam of antenna without physical movement of antenna, right? And that is possible by having a phase difference between element. So if we can steer the beam of antenna towards target without physical movement, then we can use antenna array in radar system, right? Because of these three major reasons, we use antenna array widely in many applications. Applications are there based on long distance communication. Applications are there based on steering of beam without physical movement of antenna, right? See, in majority of cases, you will be observing similar antenna elements are used in antenna array. So in antenna array, usually we use similar antenna elements. See, you can use different antenna elements as well. There is no compulsory thing in antenna array, like we should be using similar element. But because of similar elements, one can have more convenience, structure will be simpler, and it will be more practical, right? So in majority of applications, you will be observing in antenna array, we use identical antenna elements, right? In general, there are two categories of antenna array, linear antenna array and planar antenna array. Linear antenna array means one-dimensional antenna array. One-dimensional antenna array means group of elements are arranged in a single axis. Like you can observe here, see, on y-axis, dipoles are placed. By red color, you can observe dipoles are there. Those dipoles are separated by distance d, and on single axis, those dipoles are arranged. Means this is a classic example of linear antenna array. See, in second diagram, we have planar antenna array. Planar antenna array means antennas are arranged in a single plane. Like if you consider vertical axis as a y-axis and horizontal axis as a x-axis, then you can observe, see, folded dipoles are placed in a plane, right? So this is example of two-dimensional array, or you can say planar array. Now, I'll be going to derive equation of electric field for n element antenna array. So here you can observe, see, these are the antennas, right? These are the antennas. Let us consider this is first antenna and this is nth antenna, right? So here for n elements, we are delivered to derive electric field. Let us consider with this first antenna, we are having electric field, that is E1. With this second antenna, let us say electric field is E2. With third antenna, let us say electric field is E3. Likewise, with nth antenna, let us say electric field is En. So total electric field will be E1 plus E2 plus E3 up to En, right? So here, total electric field is Et, that is E1 plus E2 plus E3 up to En. Now we need to understand how electric fields are there with single elements. Like as if I talk about first element, that is a reference element, and here I'll be writing normalized electric field. Let us say that is sine omega t. Here I'm not writing E naught sine omega t. Here I'm writing normalized electric field, right? So maximum value is 1 with E1, and that is sine omega t, where omega is frequency of radiated signal, right? So what will be electric field with E2? See, E2 will be having phase difference with respect to E1. See here, this is first element, this is second element. We are radiating in this direction, that is making angle theta over here. So because of some angle over here, there is always phase difference in between E1 and E2. Let us say that phase difference is sine. So here E2 will be sine of omega t plus sine. Now see E3, that is having further phase that is getting added, and that additional phase is again sine. So with E2 we have sine omega t plus sine. So with E3 we will be having sine omega t plus 2 sine, right? Likewise, up to En we will be having algebraic sum, where with En electric field will be sine of omega t plus n minus 1 into sine. Now question is how to identify the value of this sine. Sine is phase difference in between two consecutive elements. Let me explain you how to identify it. To calculate phase difference between two consecutive elements, let me plot two elements over here. Let us say this is first element and this is second element. Spacing in between two element is small d over here, and these two elements are radiating in this direction. You can observe it is radiating in this direction, right? And see this direction, that is making angle theta over here. So here this direction, that is making angle theta over here. So this angle is also theta. Our agenda is to identify phase difference sine. See, phase difference sine, that one can identify based on path difference. So here see this element, that is lagging by some path over here. The reason is, if you talk about this distance, then here phase of this element, that will come by some delay, and that is based on path difference. That path difference, that one can identify based on this triangle. See, this is the basic path difference that is there with us, and that path difference as per this triangle is how much? D cos theta, right? It is D cos theta. If you wanted to have phase difference, then phase difference, that can be calculated based on path difference. See, for lambda path difference, phase is 2 pi. So for d cos theta, how much phase difference is there? Simply just multiply 2 pi and divide lambda with the given path difference, right? So phase difference, that is 2 pi by lambda into d cos theta, right? For lambda distance, phase difference is 2 pi. So for d cos theta, it will be 2 pi by lambda into d cos theta. Here if you observe, see these antenna elements are connected with phase shifter. So but obviously there is a possibility that we may have initial phase added as per alpha. So let us consider initial added phase is alpha over here. So what is the value of sine? This sine, that is 2 pi by lambda, that can be represented by beta. So 2 pi by lambda is beta d cos theta plus alpha, where alpha is initial phase added by this phase shifter, right? So now we have value of phase in between two consecutive elements, that is sine, right? And here total electric field, that is algebraic sum of this. This total electric field, that can be simplified in form of amplitude and phase. Let me explain you how. See here, amplitude will be sine of n sine by 2 divided by sine of sine by 2, that is what amplitude, into sine of omega t plus n minus 1 sine by 2, where this is phase. So this is amplitude, this term, that is amplitude over here with this total electric field, and this term, that is phase over here. Now here, understand one thing. See this amplitude, that is normalized amplitude. The reason is, initially I have considered electric field of first element, that is sine omega t. With second element, it is sine omega t plus sine. I have considered normalized electric field only. So but obviously total electric field over here, that will be normalized only. So based on amplitude, one can identify array factor. So let me explain you first what is array factor over here. Array factor is total electric field divided by electric field of single element. Here we have total normalized electric field, that is sine of n sine by 2 divided by sine of sine by 2. And array factor is total electric field divided by single element electric field. So you can say this normalized total electric field is array factor only, right? The reason is, here we have already normalized this amplitude with respect to single element. So you can say array factor is total electric field divided by electric field of single element, that is this amplitude only. So you can say this array factor is sine of n sine by 2 divided by sine of sine by 2, where value of sine, that is beta d cos theta plus alpha, right? And here, see this array factor, that explains you how radiation happens. Like you can observe here, we have considered radiation is happening in this direction, that is making angle theta with respect to axis of antenna array, right? So here, principal maxima that happens at what angle? That happens at angle theta, and at that angle, this value of sine, that will be zero. See, the maximum value of this array factor, that will happen at angle sine is equals to zero, right? So principal maxima, that will be happening at sine is equals to zero. And based on this principal maxima, we can identify many other parameters of antenna array. So in future coming videos, I'll be explaining you different parameters of antenna array. Still, if anything that you like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.